Hello, hello, everybody. It's 4:51 a.m. Central Time on the 28th of November, 2022. It's Monday morning here in the United States. And I've got some breaking news for you. Look in the lower right-hand corner. See this view right here? This is the big caldera at Mauna Loa in Hawaii. And we're viewing on the USGS cam here. I'm going to get a display capture open just so you can see what I see a little bit better. This is a huge deal. The center fissure or the center crack that goes across the center of the big island here in Hawaii has broken apart. First eruption since the 1980s. This is Mauna Loa. And what we're looking at here is a giant fissure or crater, of course, of the top of the volcano. And according to the webcam, we're looking at the caldera from the northwest rim. So northwest, somewhere up here. I don't know exactly where the camera is, but it's looking down into here. And you see the big crack that goes across the center of the caldera. Of course, that has now broken open and is filling up the entire center of the caldera with a huge, huge lava flow. This is just, guys, this is one of the biggest deals to happen in geophysics in many years. Certainly for the United States. And I cannot stress it enough, this is kind of the worst case scenario of the center of the caldera breaking, as opposed to a fissure or a small spatter cone or something on the side. Now, they've blocked hikers from going up here a few weeks ago when seismic signals started to show that there was the potential of eruption. However, mainstream media weighed in and said it was going to erupt imminently or very soon. That was a few weeks back. And professionals weighed in and said that it wasn't going to erupt and that they were watching it, monitoring it. That's where we left it. Well, now here it is. This is filling up. Once it fills up, it will flow out. You can see the previous times that it's happened in the past. The 1970s and 80s were the last times that we have eruptions at this volcano. This is the largest shield volcano on the planet, on the surface. Now, there's other larger volcanoes undersea, super volcanoes like Tamu Massif and others, but this is the largest shield volcano on the planet, and it is in a state of eruptive activity right now. I'm going to hit refresh on this and just see what if there's a change at all. USGS site probably is going to just be overwhelmed over the next few days. I'm surprised it's even staying online right now. Okay, so our last imagery is today at 46:06. This is local time, I would suppose, right after midnight, their time. And let's just hit refresh on it again. I wonder if there's other views on Mauna Loa where we could actually go get a good view. Let's go see. So, okay, here is a thermal of the outbreak. So a thermal of the outbreak. Let me hit refresh on this. And we'll blow it up full screen as much as we can. So temperatures, I think this is in Celsius. Is that Celsius? If it's not, it's Fahrenheit, right? Anyway, we're going in the 300, 400 range. And then, of course, we're cooler on the surface, hotter as it breaks out and flows across. This is the center rift, if you will, or the center fissure going through the center of the caldera. This is a big deal, really big deal. Okay, do we have any other cameras that are going to show it to us? Boy, I'm not really seeing too much. Now, Kilauea is also going, but this is just something that, again, we're not going to really be paying too much on Kilauea. Wow, look at that. The upper part of Mauna Loa is... Okay, so these are all the views we're going to get on it right now from the USGS until they get an actual camera up. And they should get a camera up, an actual video camera. I would think they would probably have one pretty soon. Again, let's go check their videos and see what they've got. Do they have anything on this? Have any video on this? No, of course not. No. That's way too early for them. They will have video on this, I guarantee it. They're going to have helicopters. Everybody's already probably in full freak-out mode over in Hawaii. Rightfully so. Let's get back and take a look, because once this fills up and flows out, it's going to head out. And look, it just depends on which direction it flows out first. I mean, we've got all kinds of people that live down here along the coast that are going to have to be evacuated, depending on which way it goes out. Goes out the other way, it could actually go down over this way. two or three different directions this side, and that doesn't count if there's any fissures or fractures that open on the side of the volcano, like you can see have happened in the past, where you get a breakout on the side. Think of this like a big version of over in the Canary Islands. You can get outbreaks on the side of a giant cone, even if it's a giant shield volcano. But in this case, this is something that we have to, of course, everybody in the world is going to be talking about this. This is the first large eruption at Mauna Loa, the biggest shield volcano on the planet since the 1980s. And back to it, let's go back over to the USGS site, hit refresh one more time on the thermal. So wait to see if they refresh at all, or are we going to get any new pictures? Yeah, this is refreshing now. So you can see it's actually breaking apart and coming even further over to the west. 4606, is that the last one? Here, let's hit refresh again. Okay, it is just, let's go visit the webcam. I don't know what the deal is here, guys, but they have it at 4606 and it's not refreshing. That's getting to be old imagery on this. So I don't know why they would cut it other than to say maybe they don't have a full real-time stream or it's super over inundated. But we're at Mauna Loa in Hawaii. Let's go ahead and see what the chat room has to say. Everybody in chat, do you guys have any updated information on this? Anybody know what's going on? Anybody from Hawaii in here? Anybody can tell us what's going on? Anybody have any updates? We're looking at the chat room right now, and I am recording. It says it refreshes every 5 to 10 minutes. 5 to 20 minutes. Oh, wow. Okay, well. Okay, nobody else has any information on it. I will go back and just take another quick gander at this, see if we can hit refresh one more time, and see if the image changes at all. I mean, come on, every 5 to 20 minutes. That's just not acceptable in this day and age where you can... They previously have had streaming cameras before on their site. So... I, again, gotta just bring that up. Maybe we could check the USGS site over on YouTube. HVO, Hawaii Volcano Observatory. And do they have it on their site? They should have it streaming. There's no, in this day and age, let's just go see. Let's go over to their official page, their YouTube page. Here's the USGS. Look how many subscribers they have. Hey guys, come over and subscribe up to the USGS site. Let's get them up. Oh, come over. Hey YouTube, what's crack-a-lackin'? Let's get them subscribers. Okay, check it out. They could go live with this at any time. They have an official site. They have an official page. You guys know, anybody can hit the live button here. It's real easy. You create, live, go live. They could go live with this at any time they want. They have access. There's no excuse. If I was in charge, that's what would be going on right now. I'd have a live stream going on our YouTube channel, and we'd have professional geophysicists there answering questions to, you know, try and get the best public exposure on this. That's what I would be doing, but then again, I'm, I'm just Dutch Saints, you know. I don't know much, do I? So back to it. Mauna Loa, the biggest shield volcano on the planet, is erupting, if you're not aware, and that's what's on the screen here right now. We'll go back over to the USGS page one more time. Here it is. Let's hit refresh. 4606 is the last time it's refreshed, and come on, that's not acceptable. This whole thing is going to be full. I bet you Hawaii News probably has some stuff on it, but I don't want to show mainstream news for many reasons. Copyright. They'll copyright this. The news will copyright it. Shameful. Anyway, let's go in and zoom in on the center of the crater because all my viewers in Hawaii are going to want to know. Which way is it going to flow? Well, if they're looking from the northwest rim of the caldera, down at the center of fracture, which is this giant crack that's here. And we have red hot burning lava coming up out all the way across and the whole caldera is filling. It's going to take a path of least resistance out. We already know this. So then it's just a question of which side do you think it'll go? Do you think it'll go up over one side or do you think it'll just flow out the other? And I would think it would probably just flow out the other, which would put it out this way. That's just a guess. I'm just guessing. There's no way. I can't forecast which way lava is going to flow. Although I can look, it would be just like a flood. So if we look at our elevation up here, we're at 13,160 feet. Then we go over here and we're at 13,047 feet. So we go down by 50 feet over this way. As we go this way, 13,056 Over here, we're at 13,040. So it's the same on both sides. But it looks like there's a slight ridge here that goes up by 10 feet. Maybe a 10-foot high ridge on that side versus on this side. It doesn't look like there's any ridge. Maybe right here it's a 2-foot ridge. Okay, so if it was going to flow, I'm just guessing that it would flow out this side over on the western side or southwest side and flow out down this way. But it's an early guess, and I'm basing it just on the elevation. This imagery would really help us to know if they would freaking update it, and they're not updating the imagery. Look, I'm hitting refresh. Oh, it just updated. It literally just updated. Okay, so now it's at 10107 UTC. And way back in here, you can see, here, maybe I should blow this up a little. Way back in here on the right-hand side of the screen, you can see a massive, massive thing going on there. Do you see it in there? That is huge, first of all. Just in perspective size, that's got to be several hundred feet high. Think of this like maybe what was going on over in Iceland, up the center of the crater in Iceland, the big volcano in Iceland. But then all of this cracking all the way across. Going, it is, it's a full fracture, guys, and it looks like if we're looking northwest, and it's all over here on the, if we're looking from the northwest, they say northwest, so I would think up here, and if it's looking down this way, so the camera is pointing northwest to southeast, basically, let's go back and look, northwest to southeast across here, and it looks like it's flowing out to the left-hand side of the camera. So northwest, left-hand side. Looks like it's going over this way, if that's correct orientation. But northwest could be anywhere along here. And if it's down here and it's looking from the northwest to the southeast, then we're filling across here. And that big fissure and fracture is over on this side, in which case we're not even getting a good view on the southwest side of the volcano yet. Whatever it is, it's massive. It's huge. The whole center of the crater, caldera, is filling with lava now. And these fountains are at least, I mean, this one's got to be a couple hundred feet high at least. And so this one's got to be a couple hundred feet high. And then you get the idea of how big that is. That's big. That's really big. So I shared Doing Hawaii. He's got the live stream going over in Hawaii. Now, seismic on this, let's go take a look at the earthquake activity really quick. Is there any earthquake activity accompanying this? You betcha. Multiple threes and fours going in a big old stack now as the outbreak took place. You can kind of see which way, or maybe you can't. You can kind of see which way the break is taking place across the island. It's spreading out from Mauna Loa for the most part. And if you take the magnitudes, the biggest, of course, are at the center where all the fracturing is taking place. Right now, we'll go back over to the USGS site, hit refresh one more time. There we are, we're at 10107. Again, every 5 to 20 minutes, yeah, you're going to have to do this every minute, guys. You should have a person just sitting there hitting refresh on your webcam. Now, I guarantee you the USGS officials at the HVO have full HD 4K cams on all of this. That's what's the scandalous part about this. There is no way they're sitting there in ignorance, not paying attention, or not seeing it live. You know, they're hiding that from the public right now for some reason when they should be showing it just blatantly and openly so that everybody can see what's happening. If you have links to Hawaii News, I would suggest getting them to VIPs in the chat room somehow via private message, and we can share them in the chat so that at least we can watch it on mainstream media, if that's what you want to call it. So let me go ahead and just refresh this browser one more time too, and make sure we have the most recent information. There we are. Okay, so big news one more time. Mauna Loa is erupting. The crater caldera is filling. It will most likely come out of the crater if it gets beyond a certain level of, I showed you the measurement, we're talking about 10 feet deep. But to get 10 feet deep in the center of this, The only thing we could hope on, guys, I do have some good news for you on this, that we would hope that it would just fill the caldera and not spill out and go down the side of the volcano. That is a possibility as well. But with the way it looks right now, it looks like it's coming out pretty hefty. It looks like it's filling pretty quick. So we hope that it would stay inside of the caldera. However, if you live in Hawaii, I'd be making plans, if you live downstream from this, depending on which way it comes out, I'd be making plans for evacuation if it comes out of the crater, caldera. I'm going to save this as a video. Get this out over on YouTube. It's not like this happens all the time. This is once in a lifetime, maybe twice in a lifetime you might see. Well, let's see. It happened in the 70s and in the 80s. Then it took 40 years off, and here we are now in 2022. Okay, much love. You guys be safe. I will be back on with a full seismic update in a little bit. And one more thing, I did have a warning that expired for Hawaii last night. The warning was for up to 6.0 level activity, and it expired last night. Or this morning. It's last night Hawaii time still. So last night, the warning for the big earthquake expired. And last night, going into now, this just happened. I'm going to consider that an earthquake forecast hit, even though we didn't get the big earthquake, quote unquote, with this. So if you want to hear the warning, I issued it 7 days ago or 6 days ago in my forecast for this week. Go back over and listen to it over on YouTube. I'm not bragging or anything. I just have to tell you, we did warn Hawaii for seismic. This is a little different than seismic, I'd say. Just a little. It's the biggest deal that I could possibly have to report on this week, I think. Unless something insane happens somewhere else. This is on the top of the level of something that could happen geophysics-wise on the whole planet. The biggest shield volcano erupting? Yeah, there we go. It's impressive looking, too. Check it out. Go over and check out Doing Hawaii. He's got the live stream going where he's cycling between all the cameras. I'm going to keep this one on and keep refreshing. It's supposed to refresh on its own, but for some reason it's not. USGS site, go figure. We'll see if they do a live camera on it. If anybody gets a link to the live cameras, please let me know. And I'm talking about live stream, like back what they did with Kilauea. There's no excuse. They had a live stream of a high-definition video camera on Kilauea when it erupted. This is the bigger eruption by far. They should certainly have a live stream camera on this. And if they don't, somebody should be fired over this. Okay? Get the word out to the Hawaii Volcano Observatory. All eyes are on you, and if you don't have live feeds of this, it makes you look bad big time. Peace out. Much love, guys. And remember, please don't be scared. You need to be prepared. I can tell that most people aren't going to get this out of my voice right now because I'm really amped up, but you need to be prepared for these kind of events. Now, of course, volcanic is a little different, but the big push that was taking place this past week, that's the sign that Mauna Loa and the others were needing to be watched. 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, the mainstream media was talking about this. And they jumped the gun on this volcano. They put out a false warning saying that it was imminent to erupt. Well, here we are almost a month later, and finally it does. That's why you don't put out warnings immediately, mainstream media. Not trying to lecture anybody. I just have to remind everybody that actually happened. So with a big eruption like this, it shouldn't be ignored. Mainstream media is definitely going to be all over this since it's newsworthy. And we'll wait to see in the next few hours which way this looks like it's going to flow. Or if it's going to flow out of the caldera at all. What if it dies out and just puts a new layer across the top of the caldera? That would be the best case scenario, right? Hope for the best. And word up, guys. Much love.